Peeps. Good morning, good morning, good morning. We are here today at the Conscious Contour event here at, I think it's 800 Town and Country Lane or something like that here in Houston, Texas. This is a luxury resale event. I'm here as a speaker about my book. I will be speaking, I think, around noontime about my book, and we are also selling autographed books today. So I hope you enjoy this video. You're going to see a lot of fashion, a lot of luxury fashion, and it's all benefiting sex trafficking. So hope you enjoy.
She wants to put out. If she wants to be sexy, she can be sexy. If she wants to be smart and sassy, she can be smart and sassy. If she wants to be a bum and run to Walmart incognito, she can do that too. But a lot of times when women are bridled by human trafficking and sexual commerce, they're sexualized against their choice. And we believe that fashion is a true resemblance of your own empowerment, your own freedom to choose every day. And so we love being able to say that fashion truly fights trafficking. And that's what you're here for today. She is proof that women can have it all. A successful entrepreneur with more than 30 years of experience, Teresa continues to think outside the box and has an impressive list of accomplishments to prove it. Her insights in the fitness industry make Teresa a highly sought after personal trainer. She has previously owned and operated her own health club and mentored young girls on fitness nutrition through her highly acclaimed Barbizon Modeling Schools. Wow. Additionally, her fitness talents have been utilized by one of the top two fitness chains in America. Wow, Teresa, that's amazing. Before I have you answer my question, there are a lot of women out there that, you know, want to write a book like you or be like you. Tell us exactly your process, the downfalls, any turbulences that you had in your journey to get to where you are today.
Well, thank you for that introduction.
Well deserved.
You know, my thing, I love to tell people, the only person standing in the way of your success is you. If you would just get out of your own way, you could move heaven and earth. I wrote my first book in 2010, which was called Nude, Unveiling Your Inner Beauty and Sensuality. And it was basically a self-help book to help women. You know, when we did that book, it was like we would interview hundreds and hundreds of women, and we would say, so when was the last time you were on a date with your husband? And they were like, well, let me see, my youngest child is 10 years. And they haven't been out of the sweatpants.
But it's normal.
But it's normal. It's normal. Right. So we wrote that book to help people. Yeah, exactly. And then in 2015, I wrote this book. Basically, being in the health club industry for over 35 years and being a personal trainer. And as I was getting older, I would hear so many women in their 40s and 50s and 60s complain that they wish they could feel like they were 25 again. But with life, children, work, hormones, you name it, you know, women start to settle for feeling drab, feeling yucky. The hormones are out of control. They've accepted just being round in the middle because that's what it's supposed to be like. once you get to be that age. And I'm here to tell you, you don't have to, you just basically don't have to accept that. You know, I mean, like, there's bioidentical hormones, there's all kinds of things, you know, and people are like, oh, I don't want to do drugs. And it's like, no. So this book is basically a 30-day guide on helping a woman give her mind, body, and spirit naked. And when I say naked, I don't necessarily mean you have to get naked per se, but I'm saying naked, like get rid of
skin.
Be comfortable in your own skin and get rid of all that excess baggage that you've been carrying around for years and years and years. And so basically anybody can do anything for 30 days. If I asked you to do it for 15 days, it wouldn't be long enough. You wouldn't get enough results.
They say after 30 days a habit forms.
And if you do it more than 30 days, I might lose you because you might get bored or you're like, oh, I give up. It's too hard. But anybody can do anything for 30 days. And so basically, when you read this book, you don't have to even think anymore. All you have to do is turn the pages. And every day you turn a page and I tell you what to eat, I tell you how to work out, I tell you what meditation to do. You don't have to think for 30 days. It's all in the book.
That is such amazing advice. Tell us, Teresa, also, I love how you three talk about just pushing through in your own ways. Mm-hmm. You said the same thing. You don't have to be comfortable being overweight. Let's say you're getting older and you want to get complacent. That's the problem. We get comfortable. Get out of your comfort zone. That's what we talk about, pushing through. Push through and be at the best of your potential. That's what women empowerment means. To push women to be their best. Because like you said it, no one's perfect. Only he's perfect, right?
Right.
We're humans. We're
right.
Made of dust.
Right.
We're not perfect.
Right.
We die.
Yeah.
I'm not being morbid, but I'm being honest.
No, it's true.
You
it's
know?
True.
So you have one life to live. How can you be at your potential? And your books tell us exactly how we can live our best life ever. Right?
And I tell people that. I tell people, you know, this is not a test run.
Yeah.
This is the real deal.
Yeah.
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 You know, you
get
one shot.
Again.
No, you get one shot.
Again, never.
You know, and my philosophy is, when it comes my time, I'm going to be sliding into that coffin sideways, you know, at 100 miles an hour, and basically saying I have no regrets because.
Amen.
I tell people, if you have a thought, if you have a desire, if you have a dream, do it. What is the worst thing that can happen? You fail? Oh well. Pick yourself up and do it again. I mean, you don't get through life without some form of failure along the way. And so, even like when we get back to being in shape and so on and so forth, you know, I turned 57 this year and I see how at my age it would be really easy to go, oh, who cares if I need to be in shape anymore? I'm getting older. And I'm like, no, I'm going to be like Cher. I'm going to be like all those other people, you know? I'm going to be 80 and still looking fine, you know?
Yes, yes, absolutely.
Yeah. I feel like I'm living my best life, but there's more to come.
I love it. Perfectly said.
I mean, I feel like I'm living my best, but I think you can always be better, 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 better.
Perfectly said. I love it. Yes.
I would say the same.
Yeah.
One of my mottos is to do something that I'm afraid of every day, to push that line so I can grow. So being your best is a journey.
So true. So well said.
Being your best is a journey. I see my life as on the pathway of living my best life. And so I see everything that I do is a new season, a new opportunity. It becomes a new step. And I feel like everything builds upon that last step. So what I've done differently this week builds upon what I can do differently next week, you know, and so it just begins to open up more and more into my life's opportunities so that I can say at the end of the day, I'm like you, I don't have any regrets. I don't want to feel like I've missed anything that I desire to do. I want to do everything I desire to do, and it doesn't matter how old I am when I desire to do it. I still think I can do it. Sometimes the mind thinks I can do it, the body might not be able to do it, but my goal is to be in the best physical shape so that my body can still do it too.
Guys, I hope you had fun today. It was kind of a different kind of day, a different kind of show for you. So remember this jacket? Yes. Look at, look how I styled it. I told you it was going to be more of a fashion jacket than a workout jacket. This is the cute belt that I put with it. Cute! Had a million compliments on it today. So anyways, hope you had a good time. We had a good time, sold a lot of books, met a lot of fans. It was fabulous. So next week, whole new week. Till next time. Bye-bye.